Raw 210 pounds of unguarded meat.
Just as expected, Tyson is right in the chest of Ribalta. Ribalta has problems with Marvis Frazier. Couldn't keep him off. And what he's going to have to do against the style of a Mike Tyson is to tie him up when he's inside, not to try to exchange punch for punch. He can't do that.
And that was a right hand by Tyson that at least got the attention of Ribalta.
You notice the way that Tyson's working the body. Stays very close to his opponent. I've been impressed with the way that Tyson has developed as a fighter.
A left hand knocks Ribalta off balance.
What is it going to take to beat a Mike Tyson, Burris? You have to have a good jab, mobility, you have to throw combinations. You have to have it all. And a lot of heart.
Well, he said the only film he watched was that of the Quick Tillis fight, and he hopes to emulate what Tillis did. Of course, when we talked to Tyson, he said, I don't mean to take anything away from Tillis, but if I were to fight him again tomorrow, I'd knock him out in one round.
That was a pretty good move by Ribalta. He was able to tie up Mike Tyson. Cases like this, you notice he's tying them up, not giving Tyson any punching room. And he has to keep those hands very hot. Ribalta has to keep those hands up at all times.
Big right hand again, but Ribalta stays right there, holds on. Took a pretty good shot that time.
You notice that Tyson also is starting to wing his punch, especially to the body. I think with the height advantage, he has to go downstairs first. Stay downstairs and bring those hands down of Ribalta. Because those punches that Tyson throws is going to take a great deal of wearing down on a tall man like Ribalta. Tyson throws some vicious shots to the body.
Again, just tremendous body shots, and what an uppercut. But Ribalta does not appear to be hurt by it.
That great forehand, nice and cool.
That uppercut stood Ribalta straight up.
Watch your head.
Well, this fight already is guaranteed to go longer than 15 of Tyson's first 25 fights. Impressive thing about Ribalta there was he did maintain his poise.
You got to bat away right inside. You get close. He just going to look to grab. You got to keep your defense tight. Bring him up. You understand? Use a good hard shot. Turn the intensity up, you understand?
Yes.
You can jab hard jab. You can beat this guy with a jab alone. Whenever you get inside, you want to try to keep your hands and punch. Pick him right up, rip him up to the body, rip his body. You understand? You just miss him with the two. But
you
know,
who
knows what you're doing? Your jab drop, go across here, listen to me. Where are you?
Oh, tranquilo. Okay.
Put your jab up, Jose. Go across here, you're throwing too high, man. Let's go.
Okay.
Somebody in Ribalta's corner does have confidence. I understand they made a significant bet before the fight, taking 7-1 odds.
They didn't get enough. Kevin Rooney in Tyson's corner saying, keep the jab down. Luis de Cuba, Ribalta's trainer, said his man is tough after the first round, so now we'll see.
You notice the uppercut that Ribalta threw. Those are the type of punches that are effective against a guy like Tyson. But you got to time it. At all times, attempting to throw that kind of shot is dangerous because one thing about Tyson, he has speed, puts a lot of velocity behind his punches, a great deal of power.
Ribalta being somewhat effective with the jab.
There is the uppercut again. And once again, Bill, you notice he's tying this man up, not allowing Mike Tyson to work his body.
Right break. Hold up. Watch your head. Watch your head. Nice and clean.
Well, it's an interesting technique, Ray, because he's not running like Green did or staying away like Tillis did.
Hold.
He's
watch your head, watch
fighting
your head.
A little bit of a different tactic.
Well, Rivalta stated that he needs to try to make, or he wants, rather, to make Tyson respect him. I see a mistake that Rivalta is making. He's throwing his jab, and at times it lands, but you notice the way that it comes back. It comes back slow, and it drops. So right, a counter right hand by Mike Tyson is inviting.
And there was an uppercut. What a shot. Gets off the ropes.
Rivalta's in tremendous shape to get out from that punch. Watch the right hand, Barry. It is so inviting.
Tyson's body punches are absolutely devastating. It's a good left to the chin.
All right, here I am, here I am. Here I am.
What's clear from that round is that Rivalta is a professional fighter. He's a survivor. Took a very good punch, got up, knew how to survive the round, punched back when he was in trouble.
Take a deep breath.
There's the punch. Terrific uppercut. The reason, or one of the reasons that Tyson has such punching power is that he always stays in punching range of his opponent. He's on top of him, so that those kinds of punches will frequently hit an opponent without the opponent seeing the punch, and those are the punches that do the most damage. There it is. Never saw it coming. Stunned him, but he got up and he went on, to his credit. The issue now is to watch how Michael Tyson is going to try to chop down a fellow who is a good professional journeyman.
This is the third round, and you would have found a lot of smart money saying that it would go this far.
Nice and clean.
You watch the way that Mike Tyson works that body. It's a thing of beauty. Very short, executed shots to the midsection, to the ribs.
When you sit ringside, Tyson's punches even sound differently than his opponent's. His body shots are so hard, there's a distinctly different sound.
The reason being, though, is because he pronates that fist and that glove, and he's punching very, very clean, very clean.
We'll just sit back and let you listen a little bit, see if you can tell the difference in the sound of Tyson's punches.
Are you wrestling? No.
examples right there, and then the uppercut behind it. Long left hand.
No. I break the side up, Lindo. Break, you're holding it in. Step back, let him go. Nice and clean. Break. Hold up, Mike. Let him go. You're holding. Turn him in. Hold him.
Tyson looked at Ribault at the end of that round as if to say, what are you still doing here? They've been telling Ribault in his corner to try to stay in the middle of the ring, and he did stay off the ropes more in that round. Take a look at some of these body shots. I wonder if there's more than 10 or 15 people on the planet who could live through those shots. And that, of course, is the excitement that Tyson creates, that all of us watching these who are not professional heavyweights certainly know that our chances of survival in a confined space with this man are slim and none in slim left town.
Fourth round, getting into the category of who to thunk it.
No holding. All right, break. Hold it.
We will remind you that Harold Lederman, our official unofficial judge here on HBO, is scoring the fight for us. And I'm not even sure he brought a pencil.
One thing about Ribault, he is not intimidated. He is not intimidated. In fact, the last round, Ribault's corner told him, hey, game plan is starting to work now. Either they want Tyson to punch himself out, which is not going to happen, or they want him to get careless.
Are you holding
it? Ribault's body is in, I tell you, he's in fabulous shape because he's taking some devastating shots from Tyson.
Well, he has been more effective in the later rounds, so I'm sure that's the thinking of his corner, is if he gets by 4 or 5, he will get stronger. He got stronger against Bone Crusher Smith after being knocked down in the first round. Lost a split decision that most everyone feels he won.
Tyson always in your chest, stays very close to his opponents. Ribault has been trying to throw some straight right hands, right? It's not going to work. The type of punch is going to work on Mike Tyson is the uppercuts. You got to bring him under because Tyson has that bobbing weaving style.
Well, Ribault got himself in trouble on the ropes again.
Tyson just turned southpaw.
Both those punches were caught on the gloves of Ribault, incidentally. Oh, I would think Tyson could even hurt you on the gloves. Lunging left hand by Tyson. The right hand is a little short. Another right hand partially caught on the gloves.
I think we're getting to that point where the catch-22 that Tyson has created has come into focus. I'll talk about that in a moment. After Harold, you tell us how you scored this fight.
Well, Larry, I've got the first four rounds for Mike Tyson. Based on the 4 points in which we scored, a clean punching, Mike is all over him, landing the clean hard shots, the effective aggressiveness, the ring generalship, he takes him up on the ropes. Interestingly enough, for defense, Jose Ribalta seems to be holding. That's his basic defense. You know, he's just trying to tire Mike out by holding him.
It's a survival tactic. But getting back to what I was saying before, this catch 22, if he knocks this fellow out in a round or two, everybody says he just knocked out another bum. When's he going to fight somebody? And if the fight goes longer, everybody says, well, maybe he's not quite that good. But he is in there with a professional. He is dominating the fight. And again, the point right now is to see whether Tyson can sustain his fury and cut this big man down.
And I think when you look at the fights that Tyson has taken to a decision, save the Tillis fight, he pitched a virtual shutout against Green. And according to Harold Lederman, he's pitching one here. He lost one round against Mitch Green.
Just for your information, Ray, his corner told Ribalta between rounds, okay, now you can start to dominate the fight.
I think that's long overdue, Larry. In fact, Ribalta's been giving away rounds, especially inside. You notice that Tyson throws a great deal of body shots. Starting to slow down Ribalta.
That was an uppercut by Ribalta, and Tyson right back with two shots to the body. Ribalta getting off the quicker punches there.
When those guys stand toe-to-toe like they just a second ago and exchange punches, I have a funny feeling, a funny suspicion that Tyson's punch is going to get there first. You notice when Ribalta throws his uppercut, his chin is wide open. He is so susceptible to the right hand. You notice how he throws his punches, Barry. He drops the other hand.
Ribalta seems to have lost maybe a half step here. You know, and again, Ray, the thing about Tyson is he just never seems to let his opponent catch his breath.
Well, he never lets up. He keeps that momentum. He's like a train, locomotive.
Right hand by Ribalta. But he pays the price for every right hand he throws. Me, Ray, Ribalta's legs he seems to be a little more stiff-legged. He doesn't seem to have much bounce.
But he wasn't just trying to survive in that round. He was trying to land something. He's trying to fight. And I give him credit for that. What Kevin Rooney just said to Mike Tyson was, Mike, you're sticking the joint out, you're throwing one punch at a time, and you're not throwing them with enough bad intentions. Bad intentions, mean intentions, an old saying of Customato. Let's see if Tyson can step it up here.
You know what's frustrating to Mike Tyson is the clinching, the tying up that Roberto has been doing from the very first round. It's a good move on his part, mainly because he's not allowing Tyson to get his punches off as much as he wants to.
We have a Spanish interpreter, and what he tells us went on in Ribalta's corner after that round, during that timeout, was that they told him that Tyson has never been in a fight as tough as this. Now start to pressure him. I don't know if he can pressure him, but I think the corner man who said that is absolutely right.
Yeah, because unlike Tillis or Green, as he mentioned, Ribalta is staying in the fight.
Ribalta has stand power. I mean, no one expects too much from Ribalta.
It's a combination from Ribalta and also a low blow by Ribalta.
The guy has a chin. Ribalta has a good chin. And that's what's been saving him thus far. I think what Mike Tyson would have to do is slow down, either stop Ribalta's, catch him in his tracks, catch him while Ribalta's attempting to throw one of those looping uppercuts.
Oh, no.
And also, like Tyson's going to say, got to throw more punches. Rather than one punch.
Tyson just missing that uppercut.
Right, right, run him loose, let him go. Step back. Are you wrestling? You're wrestling. Let him go. Step back. Run him loose. Watch your head.
Ribalta has taken some very good shots from Mike Tyson. Hasn't let Tyson double up as much as Mike would like to, or as Kevin Rooney in his corner would like him to. That was a good left hand.
Ribalta's fighting back. He's holding his own right now.
I think Tyson is a little frustrated because he hasn't been in a fight like this before, a fight that wasn't an early knockout and in which his opponent continued to really fight back. So we're going to see if Tyson learned anything from his decisions, his previous 10-round decisions, and whether he can sustain it. Harold, how's the fight scored now?
Well, Barry, I've got it 5-1 in favor of Mike Tyson. I gave the 6th round to Jose Ribalta mainly because Mike Tyson didn't throw a lot of punches and Jose did throw some punches and did land some punches. I think Jose's picking up the pace, as you said, a little, and certainly he's getting in some punches, and I think he takes a tremendous rep and he's holding his own.
A very succinct and accurate analysis. And I think now, Ray, people are going to start to ask, is that vaunted punching power of Mike Tyson going to be able to take out the big, tough heavyweights who he hasn't fought yet?
I think so. I think the style of Ribalta is creating a few problems for Mike Tyson. Maybe it is the height advantage. But Ribalta's been doing the right thing. He's tying his man up. He's not allowing Mike Tyson to get off.
He still has not seen, as Larry mentioned, the bigger heavyweights, the Burbicks at 227 or the Witherspoons at 230 or so. Remember, Ribalta is only 211.
But he's rangy. I think his style creates problems for a guy like Mike Tyson. Tyson also, like his corner once again stated, he has to throw more than one punch. He has worked both hands.
Another thing to mention is that Mike Tyson has never knocked out an opponent after the 6th round. So there's some new territory here for Tyson.
Keep him up. iron, run him loose, let him go.
They must have been studying a lot of films on Mike Tyson because he's fighting the right way. Every time Tyson gets close to his chest, tie him up, push his head down.
Well, Luis de Cuba said the only film they watched was the one of Tillis. And of course, Tyson went 10 rounds with Quick Tillis.
There's some tape that's hanging down what it was on the left glove of the ball.
There was a big right hand, and that hurt the ball.
Great, let him go, let him go. Stop it. We'll hit him on the break.
But again, Rivalta showing a good chin. He was hurt, no question about it.
Tyson went back to his corner like a mournful student who hadn't done his job, didn't know the verbs. There's Tyson at work on the ropes, and there's that big right hand. But Rivalta came right back. Imagine Tim Witherspoon is out there somewhere and Mr. Burbick saying, my goodness, how hard does he hit?
Quick exchange to start this, the eighth round. Well, they're appreciative of what has been a rugged battle on the part of, can't say the challenger because it's not a championship fight, but the decided underdog, Jose Rivalta. And Jose got the worst of that one. The mouthpiece goes, and Tyson is on top of him. Rivalta ties him up.
Appears to be wearing down now.
He's still got a long way to go in this eighth round, halfway. There's a big right hand, and Rivalta is about to go. Ties him up again, showing a lot of moxie.
Look at Rivalta's legs, they're shot. There's no spring in his legs. This is all instinct.
Body shot and an uppercut again. Rivalta taking a lot of punishment in this round. And another big right hand. Back to the body.
Let him go. Let him go.
And still, there are 50 seconds remaining in the round.
his mouthpiece has been knocked out, so quite naturally, he's looking for a broken jaw here because he's standing straight up too, Barry. There is no spring.
And there's a smashing left hand, and wisely, Tony Battle. Into a neutral corner. That was very smart on the part of the referee because Ribalta's arms were locked in the ropes.
Impressive round for Mike Tyson on a number of scores, mainly because he's shown that even late in the fight now he can summon the energy and the fury, which he didn't know he could do before he went 10 rounds a couple of times in the spring.
The most important thing right now, be quiet, quiet. Relax. Get your shit together, relax. I'm excited, understand?
Yeah. Let's take a look at Tyson to work. There's a nice uppercut, followed by a good two-punch combination and two rights. And there goes the mouthpiece all the way down to the casino. Later on in the round, it looked like he knocked something else out of his mouth, and it wasn't a mouthpiece, and I hate to even think about what it was. Most fighters... knockouts against good fighters are by attrition, not by just one big punch somewhere early in a fight. And Tyson has been wearing down a game opponent, and we'll see if he can wear them all the way down.
And Ribalta's going to have to muster some legs from someplace because they're not under him right now.
Turn him loose. Let him go.
The legs of Ribalta are still not there yet. The spring is left. His best bet is to continue to do what he's doing now. That's tie his man up.
Oh, another big left hand.
Oh, his legs.
And he's out. He's really out. And just on top of Mike Tyson. And Tony Battle left, take a long look here.
A right hand, the zing by the chin of Ribalta.
It's only a question of time now.
Let him go. Step back.
Look at the hands. Look at that left hand of Ribalta. Watch for him. Straight right hand. From Mike Tyson. Oh, the uppercut.
And a long, long way to go here in the ninth round.
That's the right hand, Barry. Again, the left hand of Ribalta is steady dropping. He is still dazed. He's tired. And now that Tyson, all he wants to do is counter.
Tyson's really taking his time here, measuring his shots. Actually walked in with left hand of Ribalta's.
Tyson rushed himself. Got a little anxious for a second there. All he has to do is take his time, give a couple of head feints, and drop that right hand.
Let him go.
He let Ribalta get off the hook.
Tyson getting a little bit careless, it seems here.
Well, he got a little anxious for a while there, Barry. Just pick his shot. I think he's surprised that Ribalta is still standing. Because Ribalta was hurt a number of times.
Let him go.
10 seconds remaining here in the ninth round, and it appears as if Jose Ribalta will survive yet another storm.
Watch him here.
the lion doesn't always get the antelope.
Last round, we touch gloves in the center.
Touch them quick and fast, man. In and out. Last round, don't let them get brave on you. Nice, man.
I don't know if this fight makes Ribalta a star in Miami, but he's earned some respect.
No question about it. He's not run. He's not just tried to survive. He's tried to fight the man.
Nice and clean last round.
He actually caught Tyson with an uppercut. Took two punches in return, but he did catch him with an uppercut. Only the third time that Tyson has been asked to go the limit here. Did it against Tillis, did it against Green, but Green ran from it. And Tillis tried to stay out of harm's way pretty much. Jose Ribalta has fought it. Showing its both appreciation and support for Jose Ribalta. Oh, what a shot! And Ribalta's down. He is up, but he is in some trouble.
Oh, he's seriously hurt this time, though.
Hey, how you doing? You want to continue? Yeah, hey, yeah. Okay.
Oh, no. So do you want to continue? He said, yeah, hell yeah. That's a fighter. Say that there is no way Ribalta could win the fight, but I think the official was wrong for stopping it. He had come back from those punches before. There's no reason to believe that he couldn't have survived that round.
Well, a tough way to go down to defeat by Jose Ribalta. But once again, he's another a case of another fighter who probably made more friends by losing this fight to Mike Tyson that he has in his previous 22 victories.
If anything, Barry, he gained a great deal of respect from the boxing public. I mean, he stood there for 10 rounds with a vicious punch like Mike Tyson.
Let's take another look, Ray, at the end of it all. Big left hand there. That put Ribalta down.
Well, Ribalta held his own. I was surprised and very impressed with the fact that he was able to really deal with the pressure of a Mike Tyson. He clinched, he tied Mike Tyson up, never allowed Mike Tyson really get off some good clean punches until the later rounds. Here, Tyson with that aggressive style and working the left hook, he was able to hurt Ribalta a number of times, but Ribalta maintained his composure, very poised, and was able to retaliate with some punches of his own.
And Tony Battle stepping in and saying, that's it, that's enough, after asking him the first time, and Ribalta's reply being, yes, hell yes, I want to go on. Here's a look at Jose Ribalta sitting on a stool and just kind of taking it easy here. Long night against a guy like Tyson, whose punches are just so damaging. Overall, your impressions of Mike Tyson tonight, Ray?
Well, I thought Mike Tyson fought a very interesting fight, mainly because of the style of Ribalta. Quite naturally, Ribalta's camp.